If the world governments do nothing, what will you do?
We'll have to protect ourselves.
How?
We'll see, best way we can. Not attacking innocent victims, innocent passengers. That we don't do.
Could we presume that there might be something like the Beirut raid again? Might Damascus Airport go up?
I don't know. I'll tell you honestly, if I did know what we were going to do, I don't think I would tell you.
Prime Minister, after gunmen shot up your plane in Zurich, you launched the massive retaliation raid on Beirut Airport, and yet the incidents have gone on. Doesn't this show that a policy of retaliation against governments for the action of guerrillas just doesn't work?
What did we do against the Beirut Airport? Was any person hurt? Our boys that went to Beirut, they didn't see to it that all the people that were wandering around at the airport should get out of the way.
But it didn't stop it, did it, Prime Minister? Are you saying that, in fact, you'll have to do something? Maybe somebody will have to get hurt?
No, I don't want... No, we never go out to hurt anybody, anybody that's innocent. Sometimes innocent people are hurt, but that's not our intention.
Yeah, but...
And it's not because we don't do everything possible not to hurt people.
There are people, presumably in the Arab countries, who you would say are not innocent, who might get hurt.
I think our passengers on the Swiss plane, ours and other nationals, were innocent people.
Both sides in the Middle East talk about an imbalance of power. The Arabs say that they need new weaponry to keep up with you. You say that you need new weaponry to keep up with the Arabs. If you get the 50 Phantoms from the Americans, will this in fact correct the imbalance of power in your favor?
It will correct some of the imbalance. President Nasser said only several days ago isn't the question that he doesn't have enough planes? He said, we have planes, but I don't have enough pilots. Well, supposing he gets more planes, will he have more pilots of his own? He said that in an interview, I don't remember exactly where to, that isn't a question of a lack of planes, but he doesn't have enough pilots. Israel has a lack of planes, and he says, has two pilots for each plane. And they're good pilots. That's true, thank God for that. But we've never asked, nor can we afford to have plane for plane and tank for tank. That's all nonsense. But you reach a certain point where the imbalance really becomes dangerous.
Is it dangerous at the moment?
It is extremely essential, very vital for us, that this imbalance is corrected.